Hello everyone, it's Farket here, and in this video, I'm going to explain everything you need to know about weapon upgrades. I'm going to cover absolutely everything. And trust me, I've researched the hell out of everything here.
You can fact check him.
I've spent over 100 hours testing, gone through the game files, checked patch notes, and more. Any updates or changes with patches will be listed in the description. Now the first question you may have, are upgrades worth it? Fuck yes, they are. Every weapon that can be upgraded in the game can do more damage than the katana. Even the tennis racket. Though the tennis racket might not look as cool as the katana, beating cannibals to death with a tennis racket is a lot cooler. Here's an example of some of the tests I've done in regards to damage. As you can see, the katana here, it does less damage than all the fully glass upgradable weapons. So yes, upgrades are definitely worth it. There are 5 types of upgrades for weapons in the forest. There are feathers, teeth, glass, fire upgrades, and poison upgrades. Feathers, teeth, and glass are permanent. Though you can remove them, fire upgrades and poisonous upgrades will wear off, though they can be reattached. I will be focusing on the permanent upgrades first, and then the fire upgrades afterwards. I won't be covering poison upgrades too much, as it is a new mechanic, and it will be receiving a lot of changes, I believe. All eligible weapons can hold a max of 30 upgrades, and each of these upgrades requires sap to attach them. They can all be found here in the inventory. You can add any combination of upgrade that you wish, and I highly recommend you do, which I'll get to soon. But let's go into depth with what they actually do. First off, we'll start with feathers. Feathers increase the speed of a weapon by 0.1 of a point, but reduce its damage by 0.05 of a point. So you get twice as much speed as you lose in damage. Feather upgrades are great if you're used to fast weapons like the katana. It can make it an easier transition to convert from, say, the katana to the modern axe or crafted club. To get feathers, you'll need to kill birds or build a birdhouse. Either way is good. If you want to go hunting for birds, it's easier on the beach, as you can see, much easier. Plus, there are more seagulls, which yield 5 feathers, rather than the 3 or 4 that you get from brown, blue, and red birds. Blackbirds drop 4, and they're fairly common as well. There is geese, but that's way too complicated. The other way is to build a birdhouse. Birdhouses can be attached to just about anything. They only cost 1 log and 4 sticks, so you can make heaps of them. The birds come, drop their feathers, and fly away. Happy days. The next one is teeth. Each upgrade with teeth increases damage by 0.1 damage and reduces speed by 0.05. It essentially does the opposite of feathers. It increases the damage, but lowers the speed. Teeth are obtained from hitting cannibals, not mutants. There is about a 10 to 15% chance of teeth dropping when you hit a cannibal. You only have to walk over the teeth to pick them up. You don't have to press E on them. The teeth despawn rather quickly, so make sure you pick them up. And also, don't lose sight of them. You can actually get unlimited teeth from a cannibal if you want. Just keep hitting them, but don't kill them. The last permanent upgrade is glass. Glass adds 0.2 damage and reduces speed by 0.1. Glass increases the damage of a weapon by 0.2 of a point and decreases the speed of a weapon by 0.1 of a point. Glass is converted from booze when used in an upgrade. So glass is technically booze. So I may switch between the terms glass and booze, but I'll try and stick to glass. Now to attach all these 3 upgrades, you will need sap. There are 2 ways to get sap: cutting down trees or building a sap collector. Sap collectors are the superior method, though they do use your pot. And the pot is just getting more and more useful these days. So make sure you use your pot wisely. There is about a 5 to 10% chance of getting sap when cutting down trees. It's not based on the weapon, it's based on the hit. Every hit has a chance. So the more hits a tree requires, the more likely you are to get sap. So machetes and chainsaws will probably have the most chance of getting sap. Now for the weapons. There are 10 weapons that can receive these upgrades. This includes the plain axe, crafted axe, rusty axe, modern axe, crafted club, upgraded stick, tennis racket, machete, weak spear, and the upgraded rock. All other weapons cannot be upgraded. This includes the katana, upgraded spear, club, flintlock pistol, flare gun, crafted bow, modern bow, rock climbing axe, and the chainsaw. Though I should note, the katana and upgraded spear can accept poison upgrades. They can't accept anything else though. Not every weapon can receive these upgrades. All the axes, the plain axe, crafted axe, rusty axe, and modern axe can accept all upgrades. Feathers, teeth, glass, fire, and poison. The crafted club and upgraded stick can accept feathers, teeth, glass, and fire, but it cannot accept poison. The tennis racket can accept feathers, teeth, and booze, but not fire, or poison upgrades. The machete can take feathers, teeth, and glass. It cannot accept fire, but it does accept poison. The upgraded rock can only accept glass upgrades. It can accept fire upgrades, but if you light it on fire, it lights you on fire. So best avoid it. The weak spear can take feathers and teeth, but not glass. It is currently bugged. It cannot accept fire, though it does accept poison. Here is something really important that you need to know. Bonus per upgrade decays as you use a single upgrade type, which means that the benefits will wear off if you only use one single upgrade. As you can see from this image here, this was a modern axe where I placed 30 glass upgrades on it. As you can see, the benefits start to wear off the more that one type of upgrade is placed. How you avoid this is use a mix of upgrades. Interestingly enough, if you place 15 teeth and 15 glass, you will get more damage than placing 30 glass. If you want the best result from this, add 10 feathers, 10 teeth, and 10 glass. Another extremely important thing to know, the weapons that can accept fire upgrades should only ever have 29 upgrades. Do not place 30, because you cannot attach booze as part of a fire upgrade, and that has monstrous amounts of benefits. Now we're going to move into placing upgrades. Before you place any upgrades, it's a good idea to save your game. Just in case you make any mistakes, or if you're trying to make a pattern, a shape, or be creative, you can just reload if you make a mistake. To make an upgrade to any of the weapons, simply place it on the crafting mat, attach the sap and the upgrade, and hit the cogwheel, and then start placing. It automatically pulls from your inventory. You can place the upgrades wherever you like. It doesn't affect the damage or speed or anything. When you're placing the upgrades, you notice the stats change on the bar there. On the fire upgradable weapons, keep note. Once the bar is full, it is actually at 29 upgrades. Though for other weapons, you can keep going. One extra upgrade can't hurt them. If you run out of an upgrade or sap, or you max out the weapon at 30, it will place back on the mat. If you wish to place upgrades in a certain spot, you can use the W, A, S, and D keys, as well as the arrow keys, to turn the weapon around. It can be a bit tricky to get the weapon in the place you want it, though if you're patient, you'll get it. If you're going to place the upgrades on the edge of a weapon, like on the blade, keep in mind that it might go through the weapon and end up on the other side. Also, another thing to be careful about placing upgrades on edges is that they can shoot off in other directions, like here with the feathers. The direction of the weapon it's facing also affects the direction of the upgrade. This is important for feathers if you want the feathers to face in a certain direction. This doesn't really affect teeth because they're too small, though glass shards are affected by this, though it is difficult to see them. Keep in mind when you're placing feathers that if you place them at the top of the weapon, it may block your view. Also, just if you're curious, lighting a feather upgraded weapon doesn't burn the feathers off. If you want your upgrades to show whilst you're in idle mode, make sure you're placing it on the correct side of the weapon. You could always block and that will show it, but if you want it to show all the time, keep this in mind. Upgrading with teeth is probably one of the most enjoyable because you can create symbols, write letters, numbers, or even words if you're clever enough. Or you could even turn it into a meme. Upgrading with glass is a little different to teeth and feathers. If you place booze on the mat with the weapon and no sap, a cogwheel will appear. This is for fire upgrades, not glass. Upgrading with glass is the most tedious of the three upgrades. This is because you can only carry 7 bottles of booze at once, as well as placing 5 pieces of glass per bottle. If you were to upgrade a weapon with glass to 30 upgrades, you will have to click 120 times. It is tedious. Though each piece of glass doesn't use sap, it's just the one bottle. If you cancel the upgrade halfway through, you still get the benefits of the upgrade, you just don't get the look. It might be a good idea to keep track of how much glass you've placed per bottle. It can be easy to use another bottle of booze for an upgrade, even if you didn't intend to. If you have 2 types of upgrades on the crafting mat, the cogwheel won't appear. If you're struggling to clear the mat, just press G, or open and close the inventory, and it will clear it for you. If you want to hide the upgrades, place them at the bottom of the weapon can be a good idea. When upgrading the weak spear to an upgraded spear, the upgrades won't carry over onto the upgraded spear, as it cannot be upgraded. If you make another weak spear or find another one, once you get it, it will have all the upgrades you placed on it beforehand, so you never lose them. So if you throw it and accidentally lose it, all you have to do is make another one, and they'll reappear. The weak spear does say it can take glass upgrades, though when you apply it, it bugs out and nothing gets attached. So don't do it, because it just wastes booze. If you're playing in hard survival or multiplayer, it might be a good idea if you find a safe place before placing upgrades, just in case you get those pesky cannibals coming up to you. You cannot have multiple weapons with different upgrades stored away. As you can see here, I placed an upgraded stick onto the rack and made a new upgraded stick. The upgrades will reappear on this upgraded stick. In this game, it appears that upgrades are attached to your character. This means that if a player gives you a modern axe with, say, 30 teeth upgrades done to their axe, the upgrades will revert to whatever you have placed on the modern axe. So if you haven't placed any, then the axe will have no upgrades on it. So basically, you can't share upgraded weapons. Another thing is that thrown weak spears with upgrades on them, you can't see your upgrades after you've thrown them. It just appears like a normal weak spear, which is a shame really, because if you're covered in feathers, it'd be much easier to see after you've thrown it. As mentioned before, the upgraded rock can only take glass, and it's kind of weird because you're holding onto a rock covered in glass. Also mentioned before, you can attach cloth to it and light it, but it will set you on fire. Burning Man! Forest logic. A weapon's speed and damage isn't percentage linked. What I mean by this is that the crafted axe here, with 8 glass upgrades, has 0 speed. And with 30 glass upgrades, it has 0 speed as well. When I tested the speed of both these weapons, they had the exact same speed. So essentially your speed can't go any lower than a set amount. This only affects the crafted axe and the crafted club. So if your speed goes below 0, just keep upgrading damage. It's not going to get any slower. As for the crafted club, with 23 glass upgrades, it's the same speed as 30 glass upgrades, and they both swing at the exact same speed. Now I'm going to cover removing upgrades. You cannot remove single upgrades from a weapon. You have to remove every single one. If you wish to remove the upgrades, place it on the crafting mat, place the cursor over the weapon, and press C. When removing upgrades, you will lose all the sap you spent on upgrading that weapon. You only receive 40% of the upgrades back of what you spent. Here is a table of what you lose for how much you've placed and how much you get back, for feathers and teeth only. Glass is different when removing upgrades. If you were to remove 30 glass upgrades, this would return 12 bottles. The problem here is that you can only carry 7. Therefore, you will lose a lot of booze. Before removing booze upgrades, it can be a good idea to store the booze you have left over on a shelf or make something with it. Make some bombs, molotovs, complete some fire upgrades. Just do something. Don't waste booze. Now I'm going to cover the effects of speed on the weapons. On the left is feathers, in the middle is teeth, and on the end is glass. They all have 30 upgrades. The single swing speed is relatively noticeable. Feathers is much faster than teeth and glass. For multiple swing speed, it is much more noticeable. 10 swings definitely shows how much faster feathers are. Though there wasn't much difference between teeth and glass, surprisingly. Power attack speed is not influenced by upgrades. Meaning if you use a lot of power attacks, using feathers isn't going to benefit you that much. Though if you're going teeth or glass, or both, it is much better. Block speed is not affected by upgrades. It's the same no matter what. If you're going to upgrade your axe with damage, it will slow down the speed that you cut down trees. Though vice versa, if you upgrade with feathers, it will speed up the process. Though this isn't all bad for damage upgraded axes, feather upgrades will make you run out of stamina really quickly when cutting down trees. Though if you've got a good athleticism, you'll make the most out of this. And 29 feathers on the modern axe is actually a really good weapon. It swings fast enough that the cannibals don't have time to hit you back, and the damage is still really good. On smaller trees, it's not so noticeable with damage upgrade axes. On the bigger trees, it is more noticeable. It honestly depends on what you're used to. Though upgrades do make a massive difference, you will notice it. Now we're going to move on to fire upgrades. There are two ways to do a fire upgrade: using cloth only or cloth and booze. This is why you only want to place 29 upgrades on fire upgradable weapons, because if you hit the 30 mark, you can't place that bottle of booze. And adding that booze has amazing effects. It triples the burn length, it triples the swing amount, it increases fire damage, and it also increases the brightness of your weapon, so you'll be able to see easier in caves and at night. The plain axe, rusty axe, crafted axe, modern axe, crafted club, and upgraded stick can all accept fire upgrades. In cloth only tests I did, the plain axe lasted 50 seconds, rusty axe lasted 1 minute and 10 seconds, crafted axe lasted 1 minute and 30 seconds, crafted club lasted 1 minute and 50 seconds, modern axe 1 minute and 50 seconds, and the upgraded stick 4 minutes. With booze attached, they lasted a lot longer. The plain axe lasted 2 minutes and 30 seconds, the rusty axe lasted 3 minutes and 30 seconds, crafted axe was 4 minutes and 30 seconds, The crafted club was 5 minutes and 30 seconds. The modern axe was 5 minutes and 30 seconds. And the upgraded stick lasted for an entire 12 minutes. To give you an example, night time lasts 12 minutes. So this would keep you going the whole night. Now, if you're wondering if placing extra booze does anything to a weapon, it doesn't. One booze does the same as 7, and you can only place 7 at a time, because that's all you can carry. Here's an example. With a modern axe, using 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 bottles of booze, it all lasted the same length of time. So you're getting no benefit. You're just wasting booze. And just to reiterate, using 7 bottles of booze on all the weapons did the exact same thing. They lasted the exact same amount of time as one booze. Though it does state it increases the fire damage, I haven't seen anything that could be concrete towards this. Just save your booze. Now, swinging these weapons does take time off the burn length. With cloth only, plain axe was 4, rusty axe was 3, crafted axe was 4, crafted club was 9, modern axe was 7, upgraded stick was 8. With cloth and booze, the plain axe was 14, rusty axe was 11, crafted axe was 13, crafted club was 25, modern axe was 21, and the upgraded stick was 24. Here's a table outlining the information. How it actually works is that each time you take a swing, it takes a percentage off. Based on these percentages, the higher the number, the worse it is. So the rusty axe is the worst weapon for fire upgrades, and the crafted club is the best. Though for burn length, the upgraded stick wins by a mile. There's a lot of information on the screen about this fire upgrade stuff. Basically, if you attach cloth and then light it, and then add booze, it doesn't do anything. It wastes the booze. Always reattach the cloth before adding booze, if you have lit it. Confusing, I know. Does my friggin' head in. It doesn't matter how many times a weapon gets extinguished, meaning going into water, standing in rain, putting it into your inventory, the timer will just keep getting paused. It won't remove the upgrade. So you can essentially relight it in the rain 100 times. It also doesn't wash the booze off the weapon. When you place fire upgrades on a weapon, you can't see them. It doesn't show that they are there. They are basically invisible. This is a bug that you probably need to know about. If you light a weapon as you're entering water, it will remove the fire upgrade. So make sure you light it beforehand, or just don't jump into the water while you're doing it. Something else that's rather important is be careful using a lot of feathers on certain weapons. This includes the upgraded stick, tennis racket, and weak spear. It will push it to a point where it basically does no damage whatsoever. The cannibals will almost regenerate faster than you can hit them. In this example here with an upgraded stick, I hit this cannibal about 140 times before he went down. Painted cannibal on hard. So for fast weapons, consider using more damage upgrades, as they hit fast enough as it is. Just pump the damage up and it will be a lot better. Yes, that took way too long. One of the most important things you should take into consideration when upgrading a weapon, or using any weapon for that matter, is how much stamina it uses. Because when you swing your weapon, you're paying a cost. And that cost is stamina. And you need stamina to fight. If you're using a hungry stamina weapon that doesn't do much damage, you could be making the game much more difficult than it needs to be. Here's a table of every weapon's stamina usage. Note how different a lot of these weapons are. This is the biggest reason why I don't like the katana, is that it uses way too much stamina for how much damage it actually does. It uses 7 points, and the tennis racket uses 4, but the tennis racket can do more damage. Though that's up to you, what you do. Some important things to note, all weapons use 27 stamina when doing a power attack. So if you're going damage upgrades and you like power attacks, this is the way to go. Spears when thrown always use 22 points of stamina. The crafted bow, modern bow, and repair hammer at this stage don't use any stamina. Based on the information here, the highest damage weapon for stamina per cost, if that makes sense, is the modern axe. It uses a tad more than the katana, yet it can do nearly 3 times as much damage. Another important factor is range. This table outlines the range tests I did, as there isn't any official guide on range. I had to do all the tests myself. As you can see, the redeeming quality of the katana is its range, and it also would affect its AoE, though spears have terrible AoE, area of effect for those who don't know. Though if you want to know what the best weapon in the game is to upgrade, it is the modern axe. It has the highest damage in the game of any melee weapon. Its range is pretty good. Its swing speed's relatively good. It can cut down trees, and it looks really good. I love the look of it. It looks awesome. Here are some pros and cons of the upgrades. Some of them might seem tedious, but it depends on the relevance to the person. We all value different things. So what are the best upgrades for weapons? That is completely up to the individual. The reason being, because we all don't play the same. Speed upgrades are good for katana users because it keeps them fast. But for those who like slow, harder hitting weapons, definitely go teeth or glass. Though if you want my opinion, going damage is best because power attacks do a lot of damage and they use the same amount of stamina. Just use your discretion. If you're new to this, try a combination of 10, 10, 10. If you're feeling a little bit more ambitious, go 15 of each. And if you've been playing for a while and you want to try something new, go all damage and all speed. Here's a bonus tip. With the tennis racket, if you place 30 glass upgrades on it, or 15 glass and 15 teeth, it will reduce the speed that much. And because of its stamina usage, you recover stamina almost at the same speed as you lose it. If you have any favorite upgrades or you have any questions, just let me know in the comments and I'll get back to you. And if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Cheers.